Assalamu alaikum students, today we are going to study about the alternation of generation in agrocorpus. As we know that there are two types of generations, two types of generations are present in the agrocorpus. So first type of generation in agrocorpus is known as sporophytic generation, and number two is gametophytic generation. So these are two types of generation in the agrocorpus. These two generations alternate with each other, so that's why this is known as alternation of generation. How they alternate with each other? It means sporophyte generation give rise the gametophytic generation, and gametophyte again give rise the sporophytic generation. Then sporophyte generation give rise the gametophytic generation. So that's why these both generation always alternate with each other, so that's why this is known as alternation of generation. So firstly we will try to discuss about the sporophytic generation. Actually this sporophytic generation produced through a plant body of ectocarpus. Actually this plant body ectocarpus gave rise the two types of zoospore. This plant body gave rise two types of zoospores. So which type of zoospores are produced through the plant body of ectocarpus which are involved in the formation of sporophyte? So actually two types of zoospores are produced. So one type of zoospores are known as meiozoospores, and second type of zoospores are known as mitozoospores. So actually question is that why these are known as meiozoospores and why these are known as mitozoospores. Actually these zoospores are produced in the haploid plant body. For example, this one is a haploid plant body and this is a sporangia, and this is actually a unilocular sporangia. Unilocular sporangia. And always meiozoospores are produced through meiosis. Because these are produced through meiosis, so that's why these zoospores are known as meiozoospores. And this is a haploid plant body, and these are meiozoospores because these are produced as a result of meiosis. So that's why these are known as meiozoospores. So we can write here meiozoospores are produced in unilocular sporangia. We know that meiozoospores which are produced through meiosis are always produced in the unilocular sporangia. So that's why these spores are known as meiozoospores. And these meiozoospores which are produced as a result of meiosis, actually these are meiozoospores. And these meiozoospores will germinate to produce a new haploid plant body, and that haploid plant body will be known as gametophyte. It means this sporophyte plant body gave rise to the gametophyte plant body. Now we are going to discuss about the mitozoospores. Actually, mitozoospores are produced in the plurilocular sperm. Yes, so we can write here, these are produced in plurilocular sporangia. Always diploid zoospores are produced in the plurilocular sporangia through the process of mitosis. So we can write here, through the process of mitosis. So that's why these spores are known as mitozoospores. So we can write here, this mitosis gives rise to the mitozoospores. How these are produced in the plurilocular sporangia? For example, this one is a diploid plant body, and always diploid plant body gives rise to a sporangia, and this sporangia is known as plurilocular sporangia. Plurilocular means many locules or spaces are present in this sporangia, so that's why such type of sporangia are known as plurilocular sporangia. This is a diploid plant body, diploid, and the zoospore which are produced, these are the actually zoospores, and these are produced in this plurilocular sporangia through the process of mitosis. So that's why these are known as mitozoospore. So actually these mitozoospore will germinate and produce a new gametophyte. It means gametophyte is produced through two ways. One way, from it is produced through the meiozoospore, actually, which are produced in the unilocular sporangia, and these are known as meiozoospore because they are produced through meiosis. So that's why such type of spore also give rise a new gametophyte plant body. Second type of spores are known as mitozoospore. These are produced in the plurilocular sporangia, and these plurilocular sporangia give the spore through the process of mitosis. So that's why these are known as mitozoospore, and mitozoospore germinate to produce a new gametophyte. It means sporophyte give rise a gametophyte. Now we are going to study about, firstly we have discussed about this generation which is known as sporophytic generation. Now we are going to study about the gametophytic generation. So we can write here, gametophytic generation. It means how gametophytic generation gave rise to sporophytic generation. Actually, gametophyte generation is produced through a plant body, and plant body gives rise to a structure which is known as gametangia. For example, this one is a plant body of Actocarpus, and these are the branches of the Actocarpus. These are the branches. At the tip of the branches, a structure is produced, and this structure is known as gametangia. Actually, these gametangia produce the gametes, and always this gametangia is plurilocular, not unilocular. So these are many locules which are present in the gametangia, and inside these locules gametes will produce, and these gametes will produce and come out from the rupturing of this gametophyte. It means these are the gametes. For example, these are the female gametes, and for example, this gives rise the male gametes. These are actually the male gametes. These gametes, it means I can write here, these are female gametes, and these are male gametes. These are the gametes produced through this plant body, which is known as gametophyte, and gametophyte's branches give rise a plurilocular structure, which is known as plurilocular gametangia. So I can write here, actually this structure is known as plurilocular gametangia. And this plurilocular gametangia give rise these two types of gametes. First one are the female gametes, second are the male gametes. Actually the male gametes are differentiated because of their flagella. So that's why these are biflagellated. They will come close to each other and they will fuse it. When they will fuse it, for example, this one is a female and this one is a male gamete. They will come close to each other. When they will fuse, then zygote will produce. So this is a diploid zygote. And this zygote will germinate and produce a new sporophyte. And after the germination, this is giving rise the sporophytic generation. Sporophytic generation. It means now sporophytic generation gave rise the gametophyte, and gametophytic generation gave rise the sporophyte. So that's why we can say that always sporophyte gave rise the gametophyte and gametophyte gave rise the sporophyte. How? This is actually a sporophytic generation which is produced through the meiosmospore and mitosmospore. And these mito and meiosmospore give rise a gametophyte generation. This is a gametophyte generation. And this gametophyte generation has produced this sporophytic generation. How it is produced, the gametophytic generation? Because it produced the gametangia. Inside the gametangia, gametes are produced. These gametes fuse together. When they will these gametes fuse together, then they will form a zygote, and zygote germinate to produce a new sporophytic plant body. So it was all about the alternation of generation in the act.